Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. Well, we just came off a holiday shortened week and now we're coming up to month end. Month end, of course, has a bullish bias to it, and so we are not expecting to see any selling over the next couple of days. Looking at the S&P 500 cash index, and this chart is from the close on Thursday, we were still trying to get above the 2734.38 level and the previous week's high. And on Friday, late in the day, we had a rush of buying orders going into the close, and we had a big move up at the end of the day, and we finally closed above resistance, but didn't take out the recent highs. So those highs are still in place. There's the S&P 500 cash index still on a daily buy signal, so no change in trend there. The pros, well, they're pointing up at the moment, but certainly they're nowhere near taking control over the next couple of days. There's the VIX making a new low on Friday. It had been treading water for over a week, and then finally we pushed lower on Fridays. So we're still on a sell signal on the daily chart, but we haven't moved down enough to give us a sell signal on the weekly chart. Looking north of the border, the TSX closed at the near the high of the week, up 130 points on Friday. Still really not a lot of momentum there, but we're still on a daily buy signal. Now, last week at this time, we were looking for the VIX to close below $11.32. Moving forward, we are now looking for the VIX to close this coming Friday below $12.17 to give us a new weekly sell signal. The S&P 500 cash index closed in the channel and inside the previous week's range. So that's a inside week or a week of indecision. Now, the NASDAQ 100 generated a buy signal last week and saw fall through to the upside this week. So we're still on a weekly buy signal for the tech stocks. If you look at a broader, take a broader look at the market with the Russell 2000, you can see we almost had an inside week there, trading in the channel, only up 0.37%. So the rally right now, it's very focused on technology stocks and bank stocks. U.S. bank stocks were up again, so second week of a weekly buy signal there for the U.S. banking sector. Gold stocks inside week for the XAU, down a little over 3% on the week. Looking north of the border, the TSX was up for the second week in a row, still trading below the lower channel line. Financials traded up to the lower channel line, but did not break out above the open gap. So the bank stocks are going to have to try to break through that gap this week. We saw energy stocks trade up over 2% on the week, well below the lower channel line. And just like in the U.S., we had an inside week for gold stocks. And just eyeballing this chart, you can see the negative chart patterns that have developed. We put in a lower high. We put in a lower low back in December, and now we've put in another lower low. So lower highs, lower lows, not a pretty picture for the gold sector. Looking at futures, we saw the bonds make a lower low last week before reversing, but still closing lower on the week. So no major change in trend for interest rates. There we had an inside week for the price of gold, down $25 on the week. Still looking for a close this week below 1305.08 to give us a weekly sell signal. And there's crude oil moving up, creating a new buy signal as of Friday's close. And our last chart, natural gas, making a lower low last week. And then we're coming up this week, making a higher low and closing higher on the week. So we might have put in a bottom last week. Stay tuned. Okay, folks, that is all for this week's presentation. Still not overly bullish on the market. Inside week is a week of indecision. Still have the VIX on a weekly buy signal. No change there. Yes, the tech sector is doing well. U.S. banks are doing well. That's a small part of the market. So we'll just have to see if we get continuation. Not expecting any real selling between now and the end of the month. And then I think March is going to be an extremely volatile month for the market. Have a great day, and the next time you'll hear my voice is on Tuesday morning, and at that time we'll take a closer look at the U.S. stock market.